Alrighty, this is how I would probably go about making a collar. Well, I'll attempt it anyway. Go BTO on your keyboard. That's a shortcut for the topology brush. B to bring up your thing, your menu. T to refine, O for topology. And then I would just go something like, start at the front here. That might be a bit low, so you can hold Alt and scrape through it and that'll get rid of it. So let's start about here. On an angle, sorry. Right, so go there, one there, one there, one there, and one down the middle. Right. Come back to your one here and go up and around. Get rid of that one. Didn't want to do that. Get rid of that bit. Stop doing that. Might just decrease my brush size. Get rid of that bit, right. And rejoin that straight across there. Ah, that's what we did. Brush size just killed the size of the whatsy. So one there. Cross here. Cross there. Right. Hold Alt. Drag through them. Get rid of them. Don't need them. Don't need that. Don't need that. Don't need that. Don't need them. Right. Once you're happy with that's the shape of your collar, you just tap on it. Bing, there's your collar. I'll hit 9 on my keyboard. That's my shortcut to split mask points. Not that it worked, but there it is. Right. Instant thickness. Now I would swap to BZM, which is Z Modeler. And now you can start adding more edge loops. And then start getting a bit more shape into it. So for that, I'll just grab out move brush, just move it out a tad, out a bit there, out a bit there, out a bit at the front. Right, not nearly liking this piece here, so what we'll do here is we'll get a gizmo, hold Alt and tap there, recenter it, and we will just mask that bit, tap in the canvas to invert it, and then we'll just move our gizmo, tilt that back a bit, move the whole thing in a bit, just so it's not so sticky outy. Then we'll undo that, get that out of the way so you can see. Mask that, invert it again. And we'll just fold that in a tad. Alright, now it's a bit high, so that's alright. We'll click that, go to Unmask Mesh Center. Spin that around. Bring it down. Right, now what we'll do is we'll get that out of the way, just that corner there, invert it, unmask mesh center, recenter the gizmo, and just push that in a tad, just to neaten it up a bit. Right, when you're happy, unmask it. Go to solo, come back to draw, come down to geometry, go to dynamic. Mesh contains one edge that are shared by more than two polygons. Okay, we can fix that. We'll go J. Actually, I'll show you where it is if you do not know. That should be under geometry, mesh integrity, check mesh integrity. Tells you the same message. Fix mesh, mesh fixed, mesh integrity, test completed successfully. Dynamic subdivision, Q grid to 1, put your smooth up to about 4, and then as you can see, you can start beveling off your edges. That's way too much obviously, but just showing you, that's practically the same as what it started off, and you just give it a slight touch. Right, if you want to, then hit apply. Don't forget, dynamic until you hit apply is just a preview. If not, you go back to that. But if you want it on, there's your nice collar. Take it off whenever you want to move stuff. Whoop, how do we do that? We dynamesh that. I didn't want to do that. So what we'll do is go to move, mask these corners, and just, whoop, not that one, invert it, sorry. Just move them in a tad, unmask, grab that center, invert, bring that in a tad just to neaten it all up a bit more, hit dynamic again. Ooh, get that move brush, pull that out. Ooh, take it off of dynamic. Everything works a lot better when you're not on dynamic. Why is that not moving? There we go. Obviously, the more time you spend, this is very quick showing you how you can quickly get a collar done, but obviously the more time you spend at it, the better off and neater it'll be than my sloppy bit of mess. Right. I did that again, I'd go to move, grab that bit there, invert that, and just whoop, invert that, just push that bit up. Don't know why it's grabbed all of that. Alright, for some reason, whoop. Hold control and alt, get rid of that. Now invert it. Invert. Just straighten that collar up at the back. But you get the general idea. That's how to make a quick collar. Obviously, if you wanted to turn off Dynamesh for starters and start subdividing it out, you'll get neater results. Turning off dynamic, divide it again, depends if you want a rounded one or a nice straight. By the look of your picture, you want a office one, which is very pointy, so for which you would then go back and lower that, mask that, tap to invert, go to your move, bring it down, unmask mesh center. We'll bring that right over like so, probably out a tad. And that would be a lot neater. As soon as you hit dynamic subdivision though, that's going to smooth everything like so. So you probably just want to leave it like that and then just go around using your gizmo, mask what you want to move, hold control, tap into the canvas to invert it, and then you can just move as you please to get that straighter look. Right, hope that helps you out, and good luck. There is probably a million different ways to do this in ZBrush. As you know, you can do a lot of things a lot of different ways, but that's a quick, easy way to get a mesh up and running. Cheers.